Hello, everyone, and welcome to another game of World of Warships. Today's replay is from me. Now, this battle was played yesterday on my stream, and I'm in the Orion, the tier 4 British battleship. I'm on the map New Dawn in a standard battle, and it's a tier 4 battle. We have already lost our Kuma, who sailed here pretty much in the open, and not himself sunk, but it's a low tier battle. I'm also in the division with another Orion. So let's see how this goes. Now you will see me use a mixture of high explosive and armor piercing in this battle. I'm currently here starting with high explosive. Now armor piercing might be an okay choice since I'm seeing quite a bit of broadside. But the British ships have a well, they have very good high explosive, and my idea is to first start a fire and then switch to armor piercing. Now generally here I'm moving north. You can see there is a much fleet of our team moving towards the north. We already know the enemies have quite a few ships going south, so we are aware of that fact, and we have to keep an eye on this because it might mean we gotta turn around and defend. We don't wanna get too far in the north, so we might wanna stay maybe in a more central location and see how this turns out. We already have a destroyer inside the enemy cap battling with another destroyer. I'm not having high hopes for an outcome there. Our destroyer is too alone, there are too many enemies around. This is a low tier battle, so you usually don't expect that much tactic, I suppose, and a lot more people just charging in. Now we are two ships behind already, and hey, there is a fire. Now on low tiers you can expect people to get rid of the first fire that's set on their ship. Actually it happens a lot in higher tiers as well, I suppose. Now usually, especially in a battleship, you don't wanna use your damage control for only one fire. It's not enough value basically, because then you get set on fire as well, and a problem. You wanna use it if you have two or more fires. Now you can see now he has two fires. He's used his damage control before and he is just burning. Now my division mate has already turned around because we will need to defend, or I guess we would have a chance to be more aggressive. Our destroyer here has prevailed in the enemy cap and is capping. We could try to just charge in there, but there are too many enemies and they would reset us. So the safest choice would be to defend, but in any way, if we sail in a central position as my teammate is currently doing, we can, I guess, support any offensive or defensive effort. So that's probably a good choice. Now there is a carrier in this game, but tier 4 carriers can not manually drop, so it's easier to dodge. We have some anti-air, so we might even shoot down a plane. And so far the carrier hasn't come for us. But our destroyer got taken out by the enemy carrier, so good job from the enemy carrier, I suppose. Not so nice for us though. And we do have quite a few ships here just charging in the north. Now they should be able to deal with what's up there, I suppose. Not sure what the enemies are going to do, but I'm turning around. Could have turned around sooner as my division mate did. The Orion has a lot of range, so you can provide fire support even if you aren't that close. Obviously, being in a battleship and with the horrible dispersion of low tier battleships, you wanna be as close to enemies as possible. But you do have the option to support teammates at longer range if it is necessary. So I'm turning around now. I should still arrive in time to defend against those cruisers. Our Kohlberg down here in the south is, well, he has absolutely no chance other than running away and hopefully surviving till reinforcements arrive. And those two cruisers will push on the cap sooner or later. Now I'm currently switching to armor piercing. I've continued to start some fires there. Mostly I want to use armor piercing against cruisers, or well, I want against flat broadsides of battleships. It's also, well, very strong. Now I think a lot of people are underestimating armor piercing in a British battleships. You can still have great results with it. In order to get the most out of those ships, you just wanna be switching with it, and I'm certainly not an expert on this. Yet I'm trying around armor piercing and high explosive mixture of it. But I find that switching it up a little bit situation wise can get you great results. So far it's still a somewhat even game. And I'm meeting up with my division mate once more, and we are going for our cap now in order to defend against those three cruisers. Now there is also an Orion coming in here. We have friendly Orion who might just be accepting this guy. But he has some plane troubles. And so far the enemies have completely ignored me. Which is surprising, I suppose. Now we are winning the north here pretty nicely, and we've, well, don't have anything anymore in the south, but those cruisers are pushing in here, and for those cruisers I definitely want armor piercing. Now, the cruisers will have a certain problem unless they somehow can engage us with torpedoes. They don't really have that much chance against battleships. We are way too healthy. I guess they'd need to get lucky with dodging our shells. And of course they have to absolutely avoid showing broadside. But I still have all my heals ready. I have full HP. Burning a battleship down takes a long time. Unless you can really start multiple fires, and in low tiers they aren't that great fire starters yet. So yeah, we got a nice citadel on first cruiser. And if this keeps up, then it will be in a world of hurt. Now they do have a Wyoming coming there, but the Wyoming is just too slow, so those cruisers, they, with their speed, they got too far away from their battleship support. And now the cruisers are the front line, something that you don't wanna have if you avoid it. Now I held my fire here until the cruiser showed once more a nice flush broadside. And down he goes. Now with a low tier dispersion, you obviously need luck. Even if they show full broadside, you need luck to hit, I guess, in first place, and then you need some luck that you get more than just over penetrations. Of course, the better you aim, the little less luck you need, but ultimately you need some luck. And there is the next broadside in the next cruiser, and he's gone as well. Now our offensive effort here, they are pushing hard for the cap. Even the carrier is coming with our fleet, so that's nice. And it looks like the last cruiser isn't willing to show me a broadside. Now my division mate is taking the majority of the fire here. I mean, we are both in the same ship, but it would be nice if they would shoot me a little bit more, because his health is going down, and I mean, he is still rather healthy. But if they would switch their fire to me, it would be nice. And here you can see armor piercing did a splendid job against that Wyoming, because he was showing me broadside. But nevertheless, I'm going with high explosive now. If we coordinate our fire, if we both use high explosive, we should be able to set quite a few fires on the Wyoming. And I have the wrong ammunition loaded for the cars where, nevertheless, I'm going for the Karlsruhe, I suppose, because he is the squishier target, and my high explosive would do a nice job anyway. A little bit too much lead there. I think the Karlsruhe might not be going at full speed, or maybe my aim is just off. Then again, I was drinking quite a bit of rum during the stream at this point, so I could blame that as well. Although I'm not sure if it improves or hinders my aim, drinking rum, that is. So I'm going for the Karlsruhe as well, and since the last time I gave too much heat, I'm doing so again, because I don't learn from my mistakes that fast, I suppose. So, maybe third time is the charm. Now there were some fighters incoming and planes are now gone. Our torpedo bombers are safe. You can see our carrier. He directed the torpedo bombers above our ships here so that we help him out with anti-air, which worked nicely. So, well played by our carrier. And maybe I can finally get some nice hits at the Karlsruhe. I'm not giving that much lead, but I really think the Karlsruhe is just going rather slow here. And there is a nice little citadel getting quite a bit of luck here. And got my high caliber and confederate. Now I am technically finally in front of my division mate. But they'll probably just continue to focus him because he has lower health. But maybe I can finally get rid of that Karlsruhe. Or I'm only getting overpens and he survives with 700 hit points. I guess that's also a possibility. Now it's looking pretty good for us, we are also just capping. If this was a closer battle, my division mate might have just retreated a little bit more, because if he puts enough distance between him and the enemies, he might just be out of their range and they might actually focus my fire on me. So, well, since this is only a low tier battle and finally the Karlsruhe is gone. But mostly since we are winning this rather decisively, my division mate stays with me so he can get a little bit more damage out of this battle. But the safer choice would have been for him to retreat and for me to take up the lead. When you are in a division, you can, or you should try to split the enemy fire between your battleships, I suppose. And there is a drop, but well, he has to use auto drop. He can't manually drop at this tier, and therefore I can easily dodge those. Now I'm switching back to high explosive. This armor piercing salvo did a lot more damage than I suspected. Since he was turning away, I thought let's go for a few more fires. My turrets aren't turned in that direction anyway, so while I lost a little bit of reload there, it doesn't matter. My division mate takes care of it. Now there are only a carrier and a Myogi remaining. And it looks like our carrier is dealing with this battleship, so yeah. It's only a carrier left. So let's speed this up here a little bit. My division mate survived with a sliver of health, but I guess the carrier is coming for him. And well, all the carrier needs is one hit. So I got some shells into the carrier. The carrier got my division mate, but at this point it doesn't really matter anyway. And I'm getting a hit as well, but hey, who cares? Shot down another plane. And unfortunately this island is preventing me from doing an awful lot about this carrier, but my team we'll be able to take care of that. Dodged some nice torpedoes here, and this is the win. So let's take a look at the results. Managed to get 1375 base experience, and I'm quite happy with that. So my division mate played very well as well, and he was the tank this round. He was focused down quite a bit. Now in a higher tier battle it would have been more important that I share the incoming fire, or if that battle would have been closer, he would have had the options, I guess, to just drop behind me and try to let me take the lead at some points, but it just wasn't necessary. And now if we have a look at the damage, I scored 115,000 points of damage. I'm quite happy with that in a tier 4 battle. Now I got a bit lucky with citadels there. But as you can see, armor piercing still works quite nicely in British battleships and especially against cruisers. So if you want to get the most out of your British battleship, you might want to switch it up with the ammunition. If you see battleships, it's nice to try to start a fire on them. Once you get them to use the damage control, then start a few more fires and then go for armor piercing and maybe some other targets. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed watching that, and I'll see you guys next time.